So did you happen to catch this rather interesting in the sense of schizophrenic news from Victoria? Apparently, a little bird whispered in Treasurer Tim Pallas's ear and convinced him that he needed to hit those elitist electric vehicle drivers with a new tax. That little bird has a name, and it's Infrastructure Partnerships Australia, an industry think tank and lobby group. For convenience, I'll call them the IPA, but please don't confuse them with that well-known conservative propaganda machine, the Institute of Public Affairs. Last year, at the behest of the Victorian government, this IPA presented a report to the Board of State and Territory Treasurers. Titled Road User Charging for Electric Vehicles, its takeaway recommendation was that state jurisdictions should seize the opportunity to levy a new tax on EVs. Quick out of the blocks, the Andrews government have pushed this new tax through both houses to take effect on July 1st this year. Yep, from July the 1st, Victorian EV drivers will be required to report their odometer reading at the start of each year and will be taxed 2.5 cents for every kilometre travelled over each 12-month period. This is expected to add $3,000 to the lifetime cost of owning an electric vehicle and add $30 million to the state coffers over the next 4 years. So isn't this tax unfairly targeting electric vehicle owners? Well, supporters of the new tax will tell you it's fair because the EV owners are avoiding a 43 cent per litre fuel levy that everyone else has to pay whenever they fill their petrol tank. And since they still use the roads, then we must find another way to make them pay for the upkeep of said roads. Sounds reasonable, except that the fuel levy is a federal tax, and so any loss of revenue caused by EV uptake will be felt by the federal government, not the states. So let's call this for what it is, an opportunistic money grab from the Victorian government, urged on by a bunch of rent-seeking lobbyists from the infrastructure, construction and finance industry. Oh, and by the way, sitting on the board of the IPA is one Jason Lewes, who happens to also be Deputy Secretary, Department of Treasury and Finance, Victoria. No wonder Victoria's all over this like a fat kid on a cupcake. Too harsh? Well, take a look at this on page 23 of the IPA report. Contrary to other types of reform, an early mover on road user charges will also most likely encounter the least public resistance to change. This is because those who will be immediately impacted, electric vehicle owners, will be at their lowest ebb. Reform can only become more difficult over time as more motorists embrace the technology. So while there may not be a race to roll out the COVID vaccine, there certainly seems to be a race between states to slug hapless EV owners with a new tax. Yes, Victoria were first out of the blocks, but don't worry, New South Wales and South Australia are both watching from the sidelines, new tax bills in hand, waiting to see if Victoria gets away with it. And then there is this little gem from the CEO's introduction. While fuel excise is a federal charge, yes, thanks for pointing that out, and there are benefits to nationally led reform, states and territories have an opportunity to jump ahead. In an environment of tightening fiscal settings, a new and sustainable source of revenue is an attractive proposition. Yeah, especially if you're in the business of building infrastructure for cashed up governments, right? The clear message here to all state treasurers is this. There's a chance for a windfall here, fellas, but only if you jump on it before the punters realise they're being fleeced. So you might be thinking, what's the harm if the states scam the feds out of some revenue by putting the squeeze on a few well-heeled Tesla drivers? This could be a good way to claw back some of that vertical fiscal imbalance, right? Well, I see three big issues here. Well, four actually, if you count the hijacking of our democracy by shameless rent seekers. Firstly, this does nothing to promote greater uptake of electric vehicles. Australia is the worst country in the developed world in this area, with only 0.75% of new cars being electric, compared to a 4% world average and 15% in Great Britain. Certainly, there'll come a time when EVs become a standard for Aussie drivers, and then we'll need to find an alternative to the fuel excise, but that time seems to be a long way from where we are today. EV owners already pay a huge premium for their vehicles, and we need to recognise the value of their contribution to cutting global emissions. Their choice of vehicle is helping to create a better future for us all. Any treasurer who thinks increasing the cost of owning an EV by $3,000 is a good idea obviously missed the memo about a global climate crisis. Secondly, do you really think that new tax will be hypothecated for road infrastructure? There is no such condition upon the government, so they will be free to use it for whatever purpose they choose. Thirdly, the feds will eventually realise they're missing out here, and they'll no doubt introduce an equivalent tax, at which point we'll be getting taxed twice, And that's not including the rego and stamp duty that you'll still be paying to the state. Now, I mentioned schizophrenia, and that's because as soon as this story hit the media, there was a barrage of criticism aimed at the Victorian government, and they were thrown into damage control. Within days, they had announced a new initiative to subsidise EV purchases with a $3,000 rebate. And so you wonder, what was this all for? Well, don't be fooled. There's a cap of 20,000 rebates, and then the subsidy stops. But not so the new tax. Now, I want to set aside the question of whether this tax is fair or good or bad, and ask something else. There is no suggestion here that anything illegal has occurred, but do you think it's a good idea to have government bureaucrats sitting on the boards of industry think tanks and lobby groups? And for that matter, why are treasurers being pitched ideas on tax policy from such organisations? Now, I'm sure when the CEO of the IPA put out this ringing endorsement of the Victorian government's new tax, the Treasury officials were slapping themselves on the back for pulling off such a great sting. From their point of view, this is clever politics, bringing in a new tax under the radar of the average voter. A tax that will grow exponentially over time as it captures more and more car owners. But really, this is sneaky, underhanded politics, and it goes a long way to explaining why most Australians don't trust the governments that lead them. Don't get me wrong, I love a good piece of new bitumen as much as the next guy. I even hold shares in some infrastructure companies, but I don't want my dividends coming at the expense of a healthy planet or those who are trying to keep it that way by their choice of transport. If such a tax is justifiable, let the government make its case to the people and simply increase the cost of vehicle registration. Either the people will accept the government's argument or they'll reject it at the next election. But let's have no more of this crony capitalism that hijacks and perverts our democracy. If we wanted that, we could live in North Korea. Thanks for watching.